Hi folks, we're here at the St. Louis Museum of Transportation. Sure looks like they're having a birthday party or something going on out there. Some sort of kids party. There's our miniature train. Now we're heading toward the train yard. You know, that's where they got like the big boy and everything. Oh, yes. Thank you. Here's the UP Big Boy 4006. Yes, that's the one that was featured in Trainz. Let's wait till these people come out of the cab.
Oh, that looks, so that's where the coal goes in.
Oh, I didn't realize people. We'll go back in later. Meantime, we'll look around at some of the other stuff, like this gigantic rotary snowplow, or a massive DDA-40X. Hang on. Yep, largest diesel locomotive built, next to the largest steam locomotive built. There's another snowplow, although it was a smaller kind, not like that really huge one back there. check and see if the cab is free now. Looks like there's nobody there. Can you imagine?
Thank you. loop around a little bit. What?
Whoa, half track. Hell yeah. Oh, cool. Honestly, there's so much cool stuff here that sometimes it's hard to decide what you want to see first. A lot of World War II vehicles today. Hey, that's cool.
You've seen this train.
When the last time we saw it run?
Yeah.
Oh, about 2002. So we're in waiting.
Spoon. Like the Aleutian Islands in Alaska, which were attacked during World War II. GM Abraham Lincoln. New York Central Mohawk. Just imagine how cool it was if its number was 3124. See if any of you guys get that reference. Oh, there's our old friend, Norfolk and Western Y6A 2156. If you guys remember, you've seen this in some of my older videos when visiting Roanoke. That engine actually was in Roanoke for some time. Was on loan from this museum here, the St. Louis Museum of Transportation. But then, as of a few years ago, came back here in exchange for that EMDFT over there, the 103. Well, I mean, I don't mean the locomotive itself, but for its B units. Guessing that over there is where you go to get in. Thank you. cab forward. Well, not really, but... Cart. There's a GG1. See, this one still barely just still has the Amtrak and Penn Central letterings. It's so rusty. That right there was Pennsylvania Railroad P5. Right behind it, a much more successful GG1. Of course, there's not a lot of stuff here where you actually can go inside the cabs, but I remember when this thing was in Roanoke, you could go in the cab. Same with its fellow co-worker, the 1218.